Hello everyone, in this video we will check Retouch4me Photoshop plugin, which is basically an AI tool but more specific for retouching images. So instead of using prompting trying to figure out how to retouch the skin of the image or how to heal the skin of the image, this plugin actually have it all. So before we're gonna start doing that, I just want to say thanks to Retouch4me for recommending this plugin and also for sponsoring this channel. Alright, so let's get to it. Next level. Alright, now before we're gonna start with Photoshop, we'll go and show you where you can find the plugin. As you can see, you can head to the website Retouch4me. I mean, it's Retouch4.me. Okay. And you can find in here, it's a very straightforward. You can find product, free product, and the resources. So the plugin that we're going to see today is this one that is called Photoshop Panel. So you can just open it and you can try it for free. But I will make sure to put a link where you can have like a discount if you want to buy this plugin. Also, there is another way to go to, if you have a Creative Cloud, of course, you can go to the Creative Cloud app or the desktop app actually, and then after that you can go to Stock and Marketplace, and in here you can go to Plugin and you can just search Retouch4me, and there we go, you can find it in here. I already downloaded it, actually I downloaded it from here, and it's a very straightforward, you can just download it and it will install really easy. All right, and the other thing that I want to mention is that this plugin is actually only compatible for Photoshop 23.3 and later. All right, okay, now so let's go and open Photoshop, and as you can see I have the plugin in here installed, and for this we're gonna use the cloud retouch instead of on device. Okay, so we're gonna use everything on the cloud. As you can see, you have heal, modifier, dodge and burn, portrait volumes, skin tones, a vessel, a brilliance, white teeth, fabric, clean backdrop. Actually, this is really nice, the clean backdrop in here. Maybe we're gonna start with this one. But for this video, I'm not going to cover all the details or all the options that we have in here. But as you can see, it's a really nice plugin to have in your armor for a retoucher, or it's really nice to have. I mean, it's good to have AI to generate things using a prompt, but problem with that when it comes to retouching, it's really not accurate to retouch only the skin when it comes to prompting. So it's really nice to have an option that you can be really specific using AI like this. All right, so we're gonna start using the clean backdrop in here option to see how it really work. So let's go and open an image. For this one, let's use this one that it's like it's have a backdrop in here. So let's go and open it in Photoshop. And then I will open my plugin. And in here, as you can see, we have this play icon that we can one click for it to play. And also I want to mention, if you have everything in here checked, you can just click retouch and it will actually go with this all that we have in, you have in here checked, and apply everything that you can see in here that I already have checked, and will apply it in once, in just one click you can apply all of this. But for me, I'm not gonna do that because I want to be specific, but I just want to let you know that there is an option to do that. You can just check everything like I have in here and one click on this retouch, and you can have all of them at once for your file. All right, so let's go to clean and clean backdrop in here, and as you can see, you have this arrow in here. By one click on it, you can actually see some options in here. You can see how much you want the blend to be, for example 50 30 or 100. For me, I will keep it 100 to be blend very good. And in here you can have the auto mask on or off. For me, I will keep it on, and then I will one click on this play button, and I will wait for the result. All right, as you can see, it creates a new layer on top. It's called clean backdrop. And let's actually zoom in because I'm sure it was something in here that it was not that clean. Yeah, I know it. Look at this. This is like the walking or something like that. And if we make this active again, you can see it really make a really, really nice job to clean the backdrop of our model in here. All right, this is really cool, as you can see. And the other one that I want to mention is, like, you can actually buy 100 credits to retouch. For example, I had 100 and now I have 73 because I've used this before. All right, so just keep that in mind. All right, now we'll close this and let's open another image. Yeah, this one. So we'll open it in Photoshop again. And let's open our plugin. And for this, as you can see, if I zoom in, there is a lot of acne on details that we need to remove. And everybody knows, if you do retouching before, that you have to go through each one of these to remove everything and to clean the face and the neck. Very good. And sometimes you use blur or something like that. But for this one in here, it will actually use this heel in here. It will actually use the heel brush tool. And again, you can open it and see the option that you have. As you can see, you have the sensitivity, how much sensitivity you want. For example, you can put it like 50 if you want. For me, I will keep it 100. And then I can control the opacity if I think it's a little bit too much. That's the good thing about this. It will create another layer on top. So let's hit play again. All right, as you can see, now let's see before and after. So this is before and this is after. Let's see the neck area. This is before and this is after. And of course, if you think like there is some details that you would like to keep, you can just create a layer mask on this. That's why it's really nice to have a layer on top. And using a brush, for example, if you want to go to get back some of the details, you can create a layer mask. And using black, you can actually delete . So let's see, where is it? Yeah, for example, this part in here, can actually bring back this one just to have a little bit of details in here. All right. Yeah, just to have that option, it's really nice. And of course, if you don't want, you can just delete the layer mask and you would have everything set to how it was before. All right, now let's go back and select our background and then go to Retouch for me plugin. And the next one that I want to actually try, it's this one, the skin tone in here. It's actually really nice to have this in this plugin because the skin toning, it's very different. So it's very nice to have like a very balanced skin tone. All right. So let's go back to the plugin. While I'm selecting the background, I will go to the skin tone and again, I will open it. And as you can see, you can choose up to 200 for the blend. So let's go for like 150. And then I will one click on this play button. Next level. All right, as you can see, it creates a layer that it said skin tone. So let's see before and after. If you can see, if you can notice, there is a change of the tone in this area. So let's go and see this one. If I remove the blending mode to normal, you can see it's set to 50%. So if I put it to 100, you can see all the skin toning that is actually fixed in here. All right, now we'll put it back to soft light and let's see before and after. This is before and this is after. You can see how really nice of a job doing here. Now you can see very clear what I mean when it comes to this red part in here. You can see this is before and this is after. And of course you can play with the opacity. For example, I will set it to 70%. All right, I think this is really nice. So let's go back and actually make, I will actually apply two more filters from the plugin. So I will go back to the plugin, and the other one that I want to apply is dodge and burn and portrait volumes. This is really, really nice. And of course, like there are other things, for example, when it comes to white teeth and the fabric. The fabric, I don't think I will use it a lot. Maybe if I have something that it has a lot of fabric, because it can misunderstood with other parts of the image. But when it comes to this one, the dodge and burning and portrait volumes, I think I like it. So I will start with the dodge and burn. And again, I will open to see the options. And as you can see, you have the blend and the warmth of your dodge and burn. You can set the blend to 200 if you want. But for me, I will keep it to 100. And the warmth of your dodge and burning, you can also control that between 0 to 100. For me, I will keep it to 50. And I will one click on this play button. All right, as you can see, so let's see the before and after. This is before and this is after. It's really nice, but I think it's a little bit strong. As you can see the difference between the before and after. So for me, I think I will put it around 70%. All right, I really like this. Now let's try the other one. So I will go back and select the background layer and I will open the retouch plugin. And the last one that I want to try is this portrait volumes. Again, I will open it. And as you can see, you have the blend. The blend also controls the opacity of your layer. So actually it's like 40% or 50%. So I like to keep everything set to 100. And then I will play on the button in here. Alright, as you can see, this is our layer of portrait volumes. This is where like all the contouring and everything, you can enhance all the details of your image. For example, if you see before and after, you can see all the contours in here, the nose, the eyes. Actually did really nice job to enhance all the shadows area. But I think again, it's a little bit strong. So I will put down the opacity to like 60%. And let's see. Yeah, I think it's much better like that. All right, now let's see the before and after. So this is before. And this is after. Okay, pretty much very nice. I mean, you have to keep noticing and making some changes, of course. But in overall, I think it's a really nice plugin that use AI to retouch for you. So I really recommend to check this plugin. I will put a link where you can download this and have a discount. And this would be all for our video. And again, thanks to Retouch4me for sending me this plugin. And I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and wait for more tutorials to come and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.